Ethernet is a great example of engineering working out. And so I'd urge people, as I am, is to look at it for lessons on how to solve our remaining problems. We have help, energy, healthcare, education.
Amazingly enough, it's been 40 years since Bob Metcalfe wrote his packet-based communications, his PhD thesis at Harvard, that has spawned the world's most successful networking technology. So, happy 40th anniversary, Ethernet.
Ethernet is tremendously successful. The standards work that has been done has been tremendously successful.
Everywhere on Earth, the Ethernet RJ45 jack is the same. And everywhere on Earth, PoE comes out with exactly the same voltage and exactly the same polarity. And if you've got an Ethernet device and you're in Timbuktu, you can plug it in and it's going to work.
Who would have thought when we started that Ethernet would run on the space station?
You look at the number of ports of Ethernet that are sold every year now, and they dwarf the number of people on the planet.
Think about all the components that went into building that system. Think about all the cabling. Think about all the people that it takes to run that system. Think about all the software it takes to run that system. All of these things have created jobs.
Within 7 years, we increased the speeds of the links more than 40 times. And I don't believe that there's any other technology out there that's actually done that.
And we started adding, instead of just increasing the speed, we started adding capabilities to make Ethernet suitable for areas besides LANs. So in 802.1, there was work on provider bridging, and in 802.3 on EPON.
So fiber optic is really is growing with Ethernet. You know, Ethernet buys fiber optics, they invest, get faster fiber optics, and then the Ethernet uses those faster speeds.
This IEEE standards 802.3 organization has been around for over 30 years. Okay, and it's still going strong. That's an eye-opener when you get out thinking about it.
The project continues to adapt. In fact, now we're looking at changes that are going to be necessary to allow use of Ethernet within automobiles.
And when you look into other industries and you look at what has been really, really successful, it's Ethernet.
Video studios, like in that camera, for instance, right now there's a bunch of weird cables running around, and the way it's connected and the way in a bigger studio, they're pretty big, heavy cables running around, and the switching systems are hideously expensive, the video switching systems. They will be replaced by just regular old Ethernet.
We defined 1 gigabit Ethernet and 10 gigabit Ethernet operation over electrical backplanes, bringing the concept of an Ethernet network and kind of putting it into a box and making it the infrastructure that makes those networking boxes actually operate.
I would like to personally thank all of the members of the 802.3 community for their 30 years of contributions and look forward to the next 30 years of contributions.
Don't bet against Ethernet.
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 Certainly you should not, under any circumstances, bet against Ethernet.